What is up? It's Mikey, and we got another GTA update video. Yeah, we got some new DLC, new vehicles, clothing, weapons, all that good stuff. So let's just get into it. So first up, let's talk about the vehicles. If you head on over to Legendary Motorsport, you're gonna see a new vehicle here, the Führer GT, and it's gonna run you 448K. Wow, is it worth it? Well, let's find out. And so when you're pulling your brand new GT, you're gonna notice there are no body mods. You can't do jack to the body of this car, nothing. I mean, you can paint it. You can paint it two-tone, that's about it. There are no body mods. I mean, you could lower it a little bit, change the wheels if you want, but that's it. No body mods. So if you're looking for something that's highly customizable, you can forget about it. Now, with all that said, I decided to take it out of the track. I took it to cutting corners, and it's pretty good. It handles great. Just bone stock. I mean, I had suspension. I got a best time of 106. Hey, can you beat that? Leave your time in the comments, and we're all going to be very impressed. Anyways, so while racing it around, it kind of reminded me of another vehicle, the Massacro, and I took that out, and you know, the body's sort of the same, and you already know about the Massacro. It's got tons and tons of body mods. Fully modded out, I was able to beat that time by 3 seconds, but here's the thing, I started thinking about this. Maybe some of you don't want all those crazy mods. So if you don't want all the crazy body modifications, go right ahead. It's very similar, but there are no mods to the body. So for my money, I'd go with the Dubachi Massacro. All right, next vehicle, the Canis Kalahari, but the topless version. So the topless version, 51K, it's gonna seat two people. And yeah, it's just a topless version of the vehicle some of you guys already have. Nothing really special. I mean, it does have body modifications. The front bull bar there, same thing for the rear. It's just eh. Moving on to our motorcycles. We got two new motorcycles. First up is the LCC Innovation, 92K. And it's beautiful, it's great, all chromed out, big fat wheel out back, really streamlined body. It's nice looking, I like it, I like the way it looks. And that's a good thing, because when you roll it into the shop, no body mods, you can't do anything to it. I mean, well, there's wheel accessories, and that's pretty much it. So nothing you can do, but then again, it's a beautiful bike, great handling chopper. I mean, that's the thing, it handles like any other chopper. Really nothing special here. Moving on to our other bike, the Shih Tzu Hakachu, and that's 82K. And carrying on the theme of the other two new vehicles, no body modifications. Sure, you can change the paint job. The stock one is actually pretty cool. But yeah, I mean, sure, you can do the performance upgrades and things like that. But if you want to make this your own, you're really limited. Not a bad looking bike. One thing I will say about it, damn, this thing pops wheelies like nothing. It's really easy to flip over. It's kind of fun for about 2-3 minutes. So maybe you guys that like to make those stunt montages and stuff, maybe they'll figure out something fun to do with it. But yeah, I mean, other than that, other than the ability to pop wheelies like crazy, I really didn't feel anything special about this bike. So there you go. All right, let's move on. We've got two new weapons. So first up is the heavy shotgun. This is gonna run you 13K. And here's the mod, standard issue stuff, really nothing out of the ordinary. Flashlight, suppressor, grip, you have the tints that you can do. And then we have a marksman rifle here, and that's gonna run 15K. And when you're looking at the mods, you notice it does have the scope built in, right? And that's the thing, it's like an automatic, it's like sort of like a hybrid between a rifle and a sniper, automatic. And it's all right, I like it. It deals great damage, you got the scope on there. And as far as the shotgun goes, it's got some pretty good range, even with the silencer. So if you got money burning a hole in your pocket, here you go. All right, so while you're at ammunition, they did add a bunch of parachute bags, all sorts of countries, 30 of them. Here's just a couple of them. By the way, if you want a full list of all the changes and things that they did, I have a link down below, but I'm just talking about the new content, the actual content that they added. And speaking of more content, let's move on to clothing. These are actually some pretty cool outfits. Here is the heavy, Team Heavy outfits. Looks really cool, right? And by the way, you notice these guys have helmets on. You can get those helmets separately and they're bulletproof and you are able to take more headshots. So I would say maybe about one or two more bullets you can take. Really cool looking, around 33K each. And these look perfect for a certain activity, dare I say heist. And here is Team Mast. And these outfits are running about 18K. Lots of cool colors, night, urban, steel. I think the Tundra looks pretty neat. and the mask you can actually get separate from Vespucci if that's all you want, and you can get those for about 7K. All right, so we still got more outfits. We have team outfits, and it's going on through the same colors, but it's more of a lightweight outfit, and you got glasses that go with it. Like, this is perfect for, like, some guy who's planning a heist, jewelry theft, or something like that, huh? So, yeah, those bulletproof helmets are going to run you about 20K or so. And they did add some more masks, so head over to the movie mask store, and they added these skeletal masks, and they do come in the same colors. So they sort of made it so that way you can match them with those outfits. I'm telling you, these heists are coming soon. Hey, they said heists. Coming this spring. That's their words, not mine. So this is the last team standing update. You guys remember LTS. It's that game mode you played when the game first came out and haven't touched it since. They added a lot more jobs, so I have a link down below to all the changes. They did little stuff that you'll notice when you put the game in. But if you want a full list of all that stuff, I have a link down below. Anyways, if you want to play with me, send questions, contests, things like that, Twitter, Facebook, links down below. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video, and I'll see you next time. What is up? It's Mikey, and we got some more Destiny tips and tricks. And this week, I'm going to show you how you can solo the weekly Nightfall Strike. It's a very hard strike, and they don't tell you what the rewards are, but it's usually worth it. And I can tell you, definitely worth it for me. I got 500 Vanguard rep, 15 Vanguard marks, and an exotic chest armor, so definitely worth it. If you're looking for some rare items, the weekly Nightfall Strike is a way to go. Here's how you can do it solo, and it's really not that hard once you've got the strategy down. It's just very time consuming. Let's get into it. So first up, you notice that arc damage is boosted for both the enemy and yourself, so definitely have a arc sniper. The other thing that's not really listed is you need a void sniper.